There are many talking clubs in Brighton and Hove, and there are also many walking clubs. But now there is a new club, Walking the Talk, established by former English cricketer and broadcaster and local resident Alastair Hignell. We met up with Alastair to find out more.
Alastair, we're here at Brighton Marina Yacht Club.
Yeah.
A very interesting location, wonderful views, and an interesting event. Can you tell us a bit about it?
Yeah, Walking the Talk Brighton was a copycat idea. A friend of mine in Bristol had this thing during COVID that he and his mates found it difficult to communicate. They organised a walk, but they had the masks on and they walked around the downs. But afterwards they said, you know, that was really liberating and uplifting for us to be able to communicate, chat, walk, exercise as well. And he said from there on, he had, after COVID finished, he had maybe 10 a week, and then suddenly got 130 people a week. And he now runs this group all around the country at various cricket grounds, which is where it started. And I just said, can I copy that? Because I thought it would be wonderful for Brighton that we could get out there and enjoy the sea and the sun and the air and get our exercise that we all need as we get older. But also to keep the social idea going, the communication, the talking, the idea of communicating, contact, connecting with people, community, all of the things that begin with C, wonderful things to do. And it sort of brings people together. And the sort of carrot on the top really is that we do the walking and we do the talking, which is good for us. But then we get somebody to just talk about a great life they've had, or anybody with a story to tell. And as you know, Brighton, there are so many people with so many stories to tell that, you know, we find that we've been able to do it every week and get a really interesting person talking about different things in their lives. And it creates such a buzz among the people that are here that they start joining the conversation and asking questions. And it becomes a lovely sort of conversational piece. And it seems to have taken off, and I'm very proud that it has. And it just ticks all the boxes as far as I'm concerned.
That sounds wonderful, actually. And what kind of talks have you had so far?
Well, the very first person we had was a lady called June Miles Kingston, who was a punk drummer in the early days of punk. So she knew the Sex Pistols, and so we had stories about them. We've had JJ Waller, who's the photographer in Brighton and does these lovely, quirky shots of Brighton and around about. He's been brilliant. We've had a guy from High Flying Birds, Mikey Rose, a keyboardist with them who lives in Brighton, and he's come along and talked about playing in front of 50,000 people. We've had novelists, we've had actors. Jane Horrocks has been here, Gary Sefton. We also go to people like Tim Holton, who runs the Brighton Table Tennis Club. And anybody really who's got an interesting story to tell, connection to Brighton. And, you know, as I say, the stories come and everybody's buzzing about them. And it's just been an absolute joy.
And Brighton has a never-ending supply of both characters and stories.
It does seem that way. We had David Bramwell a couple of weeks ago from the latest bar, the Catalyst Club. And, you know, that inspired a few of us to go along to the Catalyst Club that evening. So, you know, it seems to me to be a win-win situation that we hear about these things. We go, oh, yeah, I'll have a go at that. We had the singing community choir leader from the community choir I'm in. She came along and she's an inspiring person. And everybody's saying, oh, I want to join the choir. So, you know, it's fantastic. It shows what's available in Brighton. It shows that there are things we can do as we get older. There are places to join, people to see, all sorts of things. And, you know, to me, as I say, it brings me a lot of joy. And I think it's going down pretty well.
The places that you go to, is it mainly along the seafront?
Well, basically, we started off by, I started off by thinking, well, how can we do a walk? Well, how would it work? And then I had to think about where I could find a room that we could meet in. So there was a bit of a guess they were there, but we settled on Yellow Wave. Again, Katie Mintram, who set up Yellow Wave and the beach sports, she's been one of our talkers, but we fixed on them, a lovely, friendly bunch there. And we said, can we meet here? Originally, we did one talk in their lovely clubhouse, but they have lots of yoga, so we couldn't break in. And then we said, well, where can we walk to? And I heard about the yacht club, became a member in order to be able to get use of the room. And so we've now got somewhere where we can come to on a Wednesday. In my opinion, they're a bit too close together because I'm trying to get people to do lots of walking as well as lots of talking. and they're very good at the latter and a little bit reluctant about the former at the moment. So ideally they'd be another half a mile apart.
And then can anyone join?
Absolutely. I've set it up on Meetup because that seemed to me the simplest way of launching a new group. So meetup.com, but anybody who contacts me or hears about the group, yes, love to see you, love to have you join us and share things with us. And yeah, and if you know anybody, I mean, my guest list is pretty good at the moment, but you know, we're going to do this every week for as long as we can.
Might have to be every day.
So, well, you know, we're going to get somebody from Latest to come and talk to us about Latest soon.
Okay, and what about your own illustrious life? Have you done a talk about that?
No, I'm first reserve. Well, I'm second or third reserve now. We found we've got a guy who used to be an actor who's part of the group, so I've got him lined up. And there's a guy who knows all about Mad Brighton, which Mad Pride, that's what it was. So I've got him sort of just in my there. But I'm sort of there if... I don't want to talk about myself, really. I don't like doing that. But I'm there if somebody says, oh, the speaker hasn't turned up, or what's he going to do now? I'll go, I can tell you a story.
And are there any stories that you yourself would like to uncover in Brighton? Because there's so this history.
I'd love to find out about the marina, because you know it's such a great place, but it's not. It should be a great place, and you're thinking, why is it not quite succeeding? So I'd like to now find out from people who had the first idea, what they were trying to do. And again, every day, every week, we walk from the Yellow Wave to here, and we go past all this incredible building work that's going on at Black Rock, and they've done a lot of redecoration and landscaping and so on. And the trenches where not many plants are growing. I'd like to know the thinking behind that, what people are trying to achieve, how we can help, what sort of things can be done. The arches, they need a lot of money spent on this, but it'd be nice to find out about them. So I've thrown little things into a pond, hoping that I can get some responses. And I'm getting somebody to talk to us soon about the wildlife, the botany and so on, biological diversity around here. I've got somebody lined up to talk to us about the planning along the beach. And, you know, those are the sort of things, you know, as a curious person, a curious Brightonian, yeah, I want to find out about that. Wonder what that was about, you know. So those are the sort of things we want to see and share.
So soon you'll be the go-to person if we need to find out who knows what, where.
Well, my memory is not so good as it was. But no, isn't it fantastic to find things out, you know, to be able to go, oh, I wonder how that happened. I wonder what was thinking behind that. It's beautiful. And it's settled, you know, it is so good for us to keep curious, to keep inquiring, to keep talking, to keep thinking about things. So yeah, I'm it's energized me hugely, and I hope it energizes anybody who comes along.
And do you get lots of questions during each talk?
We hope so. I mean, I don't want it to be a lecture from somebody. I want somebody to get the first question and then see where it goes, so anybody can throw in, hey, that reminds me, you know, what about this, or what's your take on that. It's about everybody joining in, and that also is hugely important. Because you can sit around and go, and then you don't engage your brain, and you don't engage your conversation, you don't engage the thinking processes, because you're there. And I just want to make sure we still keep as much life in us as we can as we're getting older.
So you've not just created a kind of a fun, welcoming group, it's also very helpful.
Absolutely.
Well,
you know, my dad had dementia, and he spent the last 7 years of his life struggling, and he only came alive whenever we talked sport. He was a sportsman himself, and his memories were better when he talked about sport. And it got to the bit where you say, Dad, do you remember that time? And he'd tell his story, but then it was, do you remember that time when you did this and then that happened? Then he'd remember the mess. So it was quite a sad decline, but it was also something that made me think, we've got to do what we can to make sure that we don't, you know, whatever we can do to stop going down that slippery path, whatever we can do to help other people from going down that slippery path, then that's something that we should do and take joy in doing, which I do.
Well, thank you very much for sharing this with us today.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
Pleasure.